Okay, so today I'm going to show you my feeding station, slant robbing station, which is located just under 100 feet to the west of my apiary. And look at this big blue dry pollen sub feeder. Dry bee pro feeder. You see these everywhere. Lots of beekeepers have them. There's lots of YouTubes about them. I'm just going to show it to you here. And it's supposed to hold 20 to 25 pounds of dry pollen substitute. And I'm tamping it down here. It has about the consistency of talcum powder. So yeah, a bunch of it spilled out. Got on me too. And look what happened. The bees could smell it. They flew to this right away. In fact, once you've smelled pollen substitute, this Ultra Bee by Man Lake, you'll recognize it right away, and the bees did not take any time at all to get over here. And of course, thank goodness they're cleaning up the spilled stuff. Look how they get the pollen all over their bodies, and they rake it back. Now, is pollen substitute as good for the bees as real pollen from the trees? Because right now we've got maple, poplar, and juniper trees all cranking out some real pollen. 58% crude protein. This is not pollen, but a pollen substitute. And again, this only comes from Man Lake. It is called Ultra Bee, and it has been scientifically proven to work as a pollen substitute so the bees can start kicking off their brood. But I'm going to show you some aspects of it here, some close-ups. I know other people have shown it. There's nothing novel here. This thing is big, and this is my feeding station, and guess what? The bees remember this station, and they come to it right away. You see the bees coming and going. I always wondered about this thing because I made my own pollen feeding stations last year, and I got almost no bees going to them. So then that set me thinking, what if I got one of these big blue things that everybody else uses? I mean, would the bees use that when they wouldn't use the small bird feeder sized ones or even the little PVC pipe versions that you make yourself? They're certainly cheaper. But I think it's kind of like flowers. If you have 5 or 6 flowers blossoming in a yard, the bees aren't going to pay much attention to it. But if you have 50, 60, 100, 200, 1,000, you get the bees' attention. So I'm convinced that this feeder, because it's big and offers a lot of pollen in one location, it just might be getting the bees' attention better than my little fancy pollen feeders from last year. But I'm showing you this white insert on the bottom. This thing is kind of crudely made. But I rested this unit on 2 horizontal metal conduit pipes. That was a mistake. I'm going to show you that at the end of this video. But when you look inside, you can see, yeah, this thing does shelter the pollen substitute from rain and weather. Although strong horizontal winds that come whipping through here do blow it out. But guess what? The bees collect it even from the grass. So I set it up like this, thinking that was cool. And then we go back and, of course, look at the landing boards. And see who's bringing this pollen substitute in. Why do they even care about it right now? Well, before the environment kicks in its full load, they're going to use the pollen substitute to come in and start making bee bread and feeding their larvae so we can kick off a stronger number of bees in the spring. And this pollen substitute, Ultra Bee, I have a 50-pound bag, and I bought it last year, so I'm trying to use it up. So here we are back again. It was fun to go out here and look at them. As long as the sun was shining, we do not have really hot days. So right now, in this sequence, it's about 51 degrees Fahrenheit. The bees really are desperate for resources. And we'll show you what happens here, too, later on. But how big is this thing? It stands about 21 inches tall, which is also about 53 centimeters, or 24 inches in diameter. Which is pretty good, 60 centimeters. It has these holes in it, so you can screw it down to a board, which I highly recommend, or you can put zip ties the way I did. You're going to want to put a board under it, because that white piece that's under there just might fall right out if it's not supported. But it's cool to look at the bees rolling around here, and it lets you see at close range what their bees are doing to get that pollen to their hind legs. And notice that the pollen on their hind legs, which are specifically designed to hold pollen, it's a little darker orange than the pollen substitute powder that we're looking at. Why is that? Well, as they sweep it back and they groom it onto their hind legs, they're adding their own nectar from their tongues. You'll see them stick their tongues out and strake their forelimbs across it. And they also have mandibular glands just above their mandibles. And they will also contribute to the pollen substitute that way. And it'll stick to their legs. It's pretty cool to watch. Now look at this lid. What's funny about this is it tightens by turning it counterclockwise and loosens by turning it clockwise. I thought that was kind of funny. This gives you a close-up of what the inside of it looks like. Made in Canada. Nice, heavy, plastic, thick stuff. You might be wondering, what the heck does something like this cost? I mean, it's only made out of plastic. $129 right now at Man Lake. This Ultra P bag, 50 pounds of it, costs just under $100. And you can get it right from Man Lake. Lots of places sell it. They also sell it on Amazon. We'll put a link down there. But look what happened. The centerpiece fell out. And what you're looking at is 20 to 25 pounds of Ultra Bee pollen substitute laying on the ground right there. Other people were saying, Fred, get out there and scrape that up. That's expensive stuff. I mean, if it's just under $100 a bag, you're looking at $40-$50 worth of pollen laying on the ground. But to me, it was an opportunity to watch and see how the bees handle it when it's on the ground. And they came right out there. And it was amazing. If we did a time lapse of this, which I didn't do, you would be able to see how quickly they took the pollen off the ground. They were cleaning it off the blades of grass and everything else. Now, the other layer of that is, I wonder if anything else would come after this pollen, you know, at night. What if we had a camera on it? Would other animals come and eat Ultra Bee dry pollen substitute at night? And then the bees come back every day. And the fact that it wasn't raining and we didn't have rain in the forecast, I thought it would be a good opportunity to leave it out there and see what might happen. Oh, here they are. Not one skunk, but two of them. Plus, a little vole or something cut a hole through the ground right underneath the pollen and was drawing it in. So again, this is not real pollen. It's a pollen substitute. But look at these little rascals. They like it. Look how they get along. Oh, they might not get along. Well, I guess even skunks aren't always friendly to each other. I know what you're thinking. Can you show it in slow motion so we can hear that again? Of course I can. Oh, that was horrifying. Thanks for watching today. Ultra Bee Dry Pollen Substitute is fantastic. It works and is proven. If you want to attract a bunch of bees to it, get that big, oversized blue plastic pollen substitute feeder. You won't be disappointed. Thanks for watching.